Hello all, welcome to Netbook and welcome back to MuleSoft Tutorials. Today I'm planning to talk about how we can create an API fragment and how we can publish this fragment in a Xen. As part of this tutorial, I'm going to talk about what is API fragment, what are the types we can describe in an API fragment, and how we can publish this API fragment. That is what we are going to look into there. To start with that, API fragment is something which is reusable component in an API design. It is kind of a library, I can say, where you can make it reusable across all the API specifications. The advantage of using API fragment is you can have a consistency in all the APIs and you can reuse the existing components. An example, imagine the security schemas, which we discussed in the previous videos. The security schema can be reusable across all the APIs. Those things we can define in API fragment and we can reuse them. Similarly, the error responses. The error response should be common across all the APIs, right? Those kind of a things you can define in an API fragment and reuse them in all the APIs. As part of API fragment, we can create a trait and we can create a resource type. We can create a library and we can create a type. We can create a user document, examples, annotation type, and security schema. So these things we can define types in an API fragment and we can reuse them. As part of this video, I'm going to cover how we can use this trait and how we can use the data types, how we can use the security schema and examples. Those things I'm going to explain, as well as library. So I'm going to take the contact API over here. If you see the contact API, when I open it over here, I have defined the security schemas over here. Imagine if I'm going to create a new API called customer API, should I create the security schemas in the customer API design also? It's not a good practice, right? Again, repeating the same code. Similarly, I have examples, error 400, 401, 500. These are the examples which I want to define again in a customer API. Should I create them again? No, it is not a good practice. Data type. I have an error type over here, which is common across all the APIs. I can define once and I can reuse them. How I can do that? I can use API fragment to overcome these issues. Now go back to the design center. I'm going to create a new fragment. I'm going to select out. I can give some name over here. I'm going to say API common library. This is what the name I'm going to give. And the fragment type, you can select the root type over here. I'm going to select as a library. I will talk about what is a library and create a fragment. As soon as it is created over here, you can see this is the library file it is created over here. Let me first discuss about security schema. I'm going to create a security schema over here. I'm going to create a new folder. I will say security schema. Click on create. Now, over here, I'm not going to define all the security schemas. I explained about how we can create a security schema in my previous video. Please watch that video. I'm going to create over here one of the security schema, new file. I'm going to select as security schema over here. I'm going to say basic authorization. Okay, so click on create. The type I'm going to select as basic authentication. I can use display name something over here. I will say the basic authentication same as it is. And I will say description something over here. Okay, so this is what I'm going to give the basic authentication. So this is the one of the security schema which I defined. I can reuse this basic authentication across all the APIs by adding my API fragment as a dependency and importing this file. Okay, so that part I will show in my next video, how we can import this file into the existing API specification. Now I can go to example part. I'm going to create a new folder, examples. I'm going to create a new, then in this, I'm going to create a file. I'm going to select as other. I will say error 400. I can define error 400 over here. So I have error response over here, bad request. This is the 400 response. This is the sample file which I can use across all the APIs in my organization. So let me create a one more error file. I'm going to say other error 500. Like this, I can create all error related sample files, examples over here. I can reuse them across all the APIs over here. So I can give this as an example. So I can use this in my existing APIs. Now I'm going to create another folder called pets, create a folder. I'm going to create all the errors types like 400, 500. I can define all the errors in a traits like 400, 500, those as my responses, and I can reuse them across all the APIs. Let me create this over here, new file. Over here, you can see select the trait over here from this dropdown. I'm going to say response rate. Click on create. And over here, the trait is something you can use it for defining once and reusing across all the APIs. Like I will get 400 error, 500 error, any one of the type it will get, right? So if I say, is this trait is coming? That means if it's a 400, out of this, it is going to select, yes, it is coming. So that is how it will be. An example, I want to some headers to be passed. Those headers I can define as a trait, and I can use as, this is the mandatory headers for all the APIs. That is how we can use it. So over here, I'm going to define as a responses, right? These are the responses. I'm going to select as a responses. I can define 200 or 400 or 500 like this. All these types can come as my responses, any one of this type. So I can select, I'm going to give some values over here. I have already kept over here. So let me remove this. I can see 400, it is a bad request. And this is the response it will looks like 404. And this is how the response will be looks like my 500. The response will looks like this one. This is how I defined as a trait over here. I can say any one of this error response am I receiving or not. I can check or I can define in my API design. Similarly, I want to have some common mandatory headers. I can define as a trait headers trait. You can create over here in the trait. You can see I can select as headers. Under that, I will say over here authorization. Authorization is mandatory for me. Okay. So similarly, I want to define something like correlation. So this is the required headers type. I can define as string over here. And required, I can say true. Similarly, even authorization also, it is required, I can say. Okay. So this is how I can define an example over here. I will put it like barrier token. One token, it is going to come as a part of authorization. So that is how I can define as a traits over here. Like this, you can define all these traits, examples, security schemas in a library kind of a thing that is called as a fragment over here, and you can reuse them. You need to add this common API common library as a dependency in your API specification, like in a contacts API, and you can import these traits, header traits, or security schemas or examples, and you can use them similarly in all the APIs. Like if you create a new API customer API, you can import the same file over there also. Now, if we have this many files, if you want to import all those files in all the APIs, it will be difficult, right? Instead of importing each and every file, you can create a library over here and you can import it into this file. You can include that into this library file and you can reuse this. Only you can import this library file and you can reuse them. I will show how we can use them over there. Now I'm going to have headers, right? I will say over here threads. Under that headers, I will define as include. I will say threads. I'm going to select headers thread over here. Then responses, I will say include threads responses thread. So that is how I can include those into the library file. Now I'm going to have security schemas. Security schemas, basic path. I'm going to include security schemas, basic path. So this is how, and similarly, I have a data type also. Let me create a data type. New folder, data type, create. I'm going to say data type as over here, new file, data type. I will say error is my data type file name. I need to define a properties over here. This is the generic error message, which I explained in my previous video, how we can define this error data type. So type, title, status, details, and instance is the properties which is having this in the data type. So that is how we can create a data type over here, and the data type can be included over here. Go to over here, types over here, and then error, I can include data types, error data. So in the library, all the types of declarations like traits, security schemas, types can be included over here. And in now, in Contact API, if you want to use this, all of them, you don't need to import all of them. You can import only the API common library file, and you can use them over there. You can directly access these types. Now, this is how we can define a types, these are data types, examples, security schemas, traits, and documents. Many things you can write it in the fragment, and you can reuse them. I hope this is clear. Now, what I'm going to do as part of this today's video, I'm going to show how we can publish them. I'm going to publish into Exchange. Click on Publish, Publish to Exchange. Over here, you can define a version over here, asset version over here. It will not have the actual version. That is, it is not a exactly API specification. It is just reusable component API fragment, right? That's why it will not have any version. It will have only asset version. Click on Publish to Exchange. And you can include unreferenced files and click on Publish. So once you click on Publish, it will store into the Exchange. Now we can add this API fragment as a dependency in your other API specifications. Only if you can publish the API fragment into Exchange, then only you can add this as a dependency in your API specifications. You can see in the Exchange, API common library is available now. That's it for today. In my next video, I'm going to cover how we can add this API fragment into my existing API specification and how I can reuse them. That is what I'm going to discuss in my next video. For the documentation, you can find it in the description, the link. Thank you for watching this video. Please like, share, subscribe, Netbook. See you in the next video. Thank you.